the swinging 60s, and I'd spent 10 years waiting to be Britain's next blonde bombshell. But blondes weren't God's gift to mankind anymore. The Beatles had changed everything. Suddenly, people wanted wit and authenticity. Real girls, real boys, real cool. And not from a bottle. My husband Eddie introduced me to Harry Starks, who was getting quite a reputation for lurking amongst the B-list.
You all right, love?
Yeah.
You look a bit down.
No, no, I'm OK. Just a bit bewildered.
You'll get your chance, Rue. Aye? All these clever bollocks will never last. And look at all these women with their tiny little frippy bits. I don't believe it. I must be seeing things.
Eddie.
Harry.
You have to see you dressed for the occasion.
Oh, yeah. Where'd you get your suit? D-mob? Let me see. Kilgore French and Stanley suit, Dougie Millen shirt, Cartier watch. Elegant, understated.
Fruity, but butch.
A little out of date, but nice to see you make an effort.
You taking a piss?
You taught me to take the piss, Harry. Taught me everything I know. Ruby, want you to meet a mensch. Harry Starks, my wife Ruby.
Married and everything, why wasn't I invited?
You went abroad, I think it's the term.
Pleased to meet you, love.
Ruby's an actress.
An actress? Yeah, you look familiar.
Just character parts, really.
Oh, what's that mean?
Cushy women, blousy housewives, look pretty and act bossy, that's my job.
Bit like what you do, Harry, only nobody gets hurt.
You still shinning up and down drain pipes for a living, Ed? Buying Tatler for ideas, knocking off the rich to give to the poor.
Yeah, I've forgotten what hard work you are, Harry. Thirsty work too. Ice gin, Rube?
Yeah, don't mind.
Here you are. Have this one on me. And buy yourself a fluffy duck.
When I pull off a big one, you'll be laughing on the other side of your mush, mush.
Well, I haven't let the cat out of the bag, have I?
The drain pipe's his mistress, I'm just his wife. I'm used to it.
He gets off on the adrenaline.
He's a spent force by the time he knocks off. But at least he never looks at other women, just their necks.
Even so, that's neglect, Ruby. Necks or no necks, he should pay you more attention. That's good manners.
Oi!
And cut!
Truth was, I'd let my career slide. I was tired of humiliating bit parts. And Eddie and me were talking about starting a family. But he needed to pull off the big one to make it real.
Miss Ryder? Miss Ruby Ryder? Detective Inspector George Buchanan, we've just arrested your husband, Eddie.
What?
Could we have this conversation down at the station, please?
I was off the books the minute he went to trial. He got 5 years. Work dried up completely and we lost the house.
We've had a whip round. It's just a few bob. Thought we could use it. Eddie's asked me to come and see you.
I see.
It's just that you being an actress and meeting loads of actors, Eddie's worried certain people, certain men, might try it on.
So he sent you to protect me?
Yeah, I suppose.
And what happens if you try it on?
How do you mean?
Well, you're a man.
Yeah, there is that.
You could try it on right now.
Well, I wouldn't.
Why not?
I just wouldn't.
Immune to my charms, are you?
Yeah. Something like that. Listen, do you want to come and see my club? Eddie reckon I could take you out once or twice, just for fun, be a laugh.
What do you think about it?
I think it's a good idea. It's in the West End. It's called a Stardust. You might have heard of it. We get loads of actors, pop stars, politicians. And you'd be doing me a favour.
Harry had a talent for finding people, just when they were becoming lost. Of course I knew about the Stardust and the heavy mob Harry had collected there.
This is Ruby Ryder.
Hello.
Ruby's a film star.
I knew what he did for a living.
That's Manny and John.
Eddie warned me about the long firms, the short cons, the dodgy property deal in Africa. I was in show business, I didn't care. I was used to crooks. And in those days, everybody who was somebody had a gangster connection.
Champagne.
It was the height of fashion.
Ah, and this... This is my young friend, Tommy.
Hello.
You're Ruby Ryder. You're really famous, aren't you?
No, just notorious.
Yeah, but you was in the newspapers and everything.
Tommy.
She was.
Tommy wants to be an actor, Ruby.
Oh, spare yourself the agony, love.
He used to be a boxer, but I talked him out of it on account of he was so bloody useless. He would have ruined his looks.
Very wise.
Nah, Tom's going to be a star and I'm going to be his manager, isn't that right, Tom?
I don't know, do I?
Hey. He's gone all shy. Look at that face. Like a baby's bum.
Beat Group's room.
That's where the money is. They're so peeled up, they play for nothing. They just play for the buzz. With them and Tommy, I'm going to start a stable of stars. Like Brian Epstein.
And why not? He was a Jewish homosexual wide boy with money and guts.
About you, Bill?
Thanks, Ruby.
He was collecting me just like he collected everyone else who was there.
What are you doing next?
Well, I'm not busy right now. I've been reading some scripts, but that's about it.
Having fun?
Yeah. Yeah, I am, Harry. I've had a good night. I'm glad I came.
I think you're good at this, Ru.
Good at what?
Good at people. Everyone loves you. Tommy adores you, I can tell.
Really?
Yeah, why don't you take him in hand? Teach him a few tricks of the trade.
Oh, no, I can't. I can't, Harry. I can't.
Of course you can. Tom? Tom? Sit down. Ruby's going to give you a few pointers.
No, I'm a bit rusty.
Rusty? You're so modest. Isn't she modest?
Yeah, modest, yeah.
Oh, I am.
I think you're going to fit right in here, Ruby. Where are we going? To the top.
Cheers.
You all right? One step. There you go.
Don't do yourself a mischief, sweetheart. You're only little. Isn't he nicer, Tommy? I think he's lovely.
Yeah. 1 month's rent. The keys.
Harry, you're too generous.
No, I haven't finished yet. Tommy's going to help you unpack in exchange for his first lesson.
Lesson?
Yeah, acting lesson. Come on, Rube, do it properly. No one gets something for nothing, do they?
Because we don't belong in this nut house of a city.
Tommy seemed to be in Harry's shadow so much, I just wanted to encourage him.
Carpenters. A carpenter is allowed to whistle.
A carpenter is allowed to whistle.
A carpenter. Carpenters is allowed to whistle.
It's good, Tommy. It's good.
Willie walks in from the entrance of the
Shall
house.
Shall we have a cup of tea? They really were my friends. I enjoyed the company, and him being queer meant that no one could point a finger.
Yeah.
Any shirts, that cloth?
Yeah.
No, you can't go in there.
That's too good.
Beautiful.
Ta-da!
watch and learn, Tommy. Ready?
Yeah.
Embrace me, my sweet embraceable you. Embrace me, you irreplaceable you. Just one look at you, my heart grew tipsy in me. You and you alone bring out the gypsy in me. I love all the many charms about you. Above all,
and now, here he is, the man you've all been waiting for, the cry guy, the Prince of Wales, Mr. Emotion himself. A warm welcome, please. Put your hands together and let's loudly laud the legendary Lacrimose Lochinvar, the Nabob of Sob, Mr. Johnny Ray.
Now, watch how he carries himself, his attitude. See, it's all about attitude.
If your sweetheart sends a letter of goodbye, it's no secret you feel better if you cry.
When it came to show business, Harry was just too sentimental. He would only book the acts that he liked, and they were always woefully out of fashion.
Any special?
Don't you sometimes think
he's come over to avoid back taxes. He's been doing a club circuit up north. He's off the booze as well.
If your heart aches, seem to...
You'll be next, Tom. Up there under the lights. You'll be in the West End soon, my son, I can tell.
And your blues keep getting bluer.
My mum's going to love you a bit. Hello, Mum.
Hello, Harry, love. I'm lovely to see you.
Come in, dear. And you? This is my young friend, Tommy.
Hello, love.
That's my girlfriend, Ruby.
Hello, dear.
My mum and Auntie May.
Nice to meet you.
Sit down. Come and sit next to you, babe. Oh. You're a young one, aren't you?
Don't know where he finds them, do you?
What have you been up to?
What?
Look at you. Eyes like two burnt holes in a blanket.
Oh, you're a naughty boy.
Born to hang. That's what he is.
Look at this. Look at him. All dressed up like a spick. Who do you think you are, fannying about with your goy nightclubs and your show business? You're a ponce.
Hello, Dad. You're in a good mood for a change. Come and give us a kiss, you strolly old spiv.
Don't you call me a spiv, chum. I was a fire warden in the war. I put out fires with my bit. I put out fire bombs with my bare hands. I had guts. Guts, see?
All right, don't get out of your pram.
Don't get out of my pram. I was a tough bastard. You couldn't even spell the word T. tough. You big Nancy boy.
Oh, come and sit down. Have a nice cup of tea and a biscuit. It won't kill you.
I'm your bum boy.
Yeah, well, you are my bum boy.
Well, they don't have to know that.
Yeah, but you are. I ain't ashamed.
Your dad went berserk.
Tommy, I am what I am. So are you.
I ain't what you are.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I ain't what you are. I know that.
Tommy, I'm your friend. Oi, I'm the best fucking friend you ever had.
Yeah, all right. Don't rub it in.
Come on, killer, let's
piss
go
off.
For
Leave me alone.
Tommy, don't be like that.
Yeah, well, leave me alone then.
Tommy! Tommy! Hold on! Sometimes I wonder about that boy.
He's young. It can't be easy for him. You're twice his age. No offence, Harry, but at his age, he should be hanging out with his mates.
He hasn't got any mates.
What, he just wants to have fun?
I don't know what he wants. What do kids want nowadays, eh? I'd give him anything.
He just wants to be himself.
How do you mean?
It's what kids want. They want to find themselves.
How do you mean, find himself? What does that mean?
It's just an expression.
Find themselves? What a load of old rubbish. Scotch for the lady, large one for me.
Harry, we're on a door split with a band. If this keeps up, we'll have nothing to split.
Is that it?
Yeah.
Look at this place, it's as dead as a bleeding dodo.
Thanks.
Chin chin. Rube. No wonder Tommy wants out. He took one look at me, old man, saw the writing on the wall, the poor little bugger.
He doesn't want out. Just growing pains.
What if I lose the club? I'm nothing without the Stardust.
You've got to learn to adapt. Make a few changes. Do something.
disc that's different. It really swings. It's really terrific the way he sings. Give it five. Really purist, tremendous.
Hello,
darling. Hello,
strippers.
No, they're not strippers. They're erotic the dancers. So terrific, like Bobby V. I love. Don't get the hang of it.
If you're going to do this, do it properly.
He's a disc that's different. It really swings. It's really terrific.
Stick it to
the way he sings.
I enjoy it. Enjoy it. Sex.
I love the army. Can't go up. I do
the music, Harry. You know, we need more girls.
How come?
Trust me.
I'll give you five.
Harry offered me a wage. I could pay my own rent now. I was wary of becoming too involved in his world, but it felt a lot better to be standing on my own two feet. It wasn't exactly the career I'd imagined, but with Harry, nothing was what you'd imagine. I was thinking about costumes, Harry.
Costumes?
No, sequins, all sparkly. Feathers.
Feathers, yeah, that'd be nice. How do you know all this?
Why, how do you think I got my equity card?
I don't know, how?
Well, how do you think?
What, you was a stripper?
Well, I went to charm school as well, but I didn't make a career out of it.
You're joking. You went to charm school?
The J. Arthur rank charm. Don't get excited, Harry.
At the Stardust was a sensation. The punters loved it. Harry was happy.
How are you?
Even Tommy was lightening up.
All right, Tommy.
Yeah.
I'll see you later. You all right, George?
That is Ruby Ryder.
Yeah? What, you want to meet her?
Yeah.
Someone for you to meet, Rube. Detective Inspector George Mooney, Miss Ruby Ryder.
I'll be delighted to meet you, Ruby.
Charmed, I'm sure.
I've actually seen some of your films.
Not exactly cinema classics.
No, but you've got class and attitude. It was like you knew they were trashy rubbish, but you was always somehow above it all.
Probably why I never got anywhere, isn't it?
Well, I'm sure being married to a convicted criminal doesn't help either.
Excuse me, Inspector.
Be nice. I'm not here for my own pleasure, Miss Ryder. I have to obtain authorization from the Commissioner himself to attend theatrical performances that might be of an obscene nature, just to make sure it's all above board.
Well, now you've had a good look, what do you think?
Yes. No, yes. All very tastefully done, my dear. I'm delighted to tell you that my report will recommend no further investigation.
Well, that's marvellous, George.
Congratulations on a successful new enterprise. Real class, Harry. I mean, not exactly the Folies Bergère, but you've gone up in my estimation.
Stop me long. Just come round to bring you this.
What's that?
Door split.
What, is that it?
It's costly business, do it properly. What if National Insurance cut for the old bill? We're never going to make any proper money. I've got to get in touch with Mooney. I've tried setting him up with Tarts. He doesn't want to know. He's taken a shine to you. Why don't you be nice to him and find out what a really big racket is, and find out what he's really up to?
So I'm the bait?
It's a favour, Ruth.
We live, as they say, in the permissive age, but, you see, as laws become more liberal, they have to be more tightly regulated. The whole point of permissiveness is permission. Filth, depravity, we can only allow so much.
How much is too much?
Well, I'll put it this way. Up to a point, I'd be delighted to allow certain things as long as I've got something out of it.
What things?
Ruby, relax. One thing at a time. Would like to think you could enjoy my company just for a little bit once in a while.
What things, Inspector?
Well, there's a lot of money to be made in publishing. I could put you on a hefty commission.
Publishing?
Publishing.
It was a shrewd deal on Harry's part. The pawn trade was booming. Everybody wanted a piece of it, and the money was ridiculous.
I've seen bigger tits on a greyhound.
Don't knock it, they sell like hotcakes.
Nice one. What do you see first then?
First thing, boss.
Put it back. Disgusting.
Harry was still pursuing his dream of becoming the last great impresario. That's why he liked having me around. I was a link, however tenuous, with legitimate show business.
What happened to you?
When he's in a mood, he takes it out on me.
Do you want me to have a word?
A bit late for that, innit?
Everybody.
Bill here would have dragged my sorry ass around all your British working man's clubs till I'm in a wheelchair.
Oh, please.
But Judy's gonna look after me.
Are you a fan, Harry?
Are you kidding? Harry loves Judy Garland. Don't you, Harry?
Yeah, I've got one or two long players.
He's got every record she ever made.
All right, Tommy.
Pictures on the wall and everything. It's mental.
Harry tells me you want to be an actor when you grow up.
Yeah. Well, I am grown up. And Ruby's helping me. Aren't you, Ruby?
Do what I can, yeah.
Oh. All he needs is a bit of luck.
Hey, you know what Sophie Tucker once said to me? Johnny, you and I have paid our dues, but these kids today, they all come up so fast.
It's not what you know, it's who you know. Isn't that right, Ruby?
And who you blow. That's right, kid, and don't you forget it.
Hey, what are you doing New Year? Judy's in town. She's got a residency at the Talk of the Town.
We thought we'd go and give the old gal some support. She sure as hell needs it.
What, you know her?
I'm sure. Well, I know her daughter Liza better. But me and Judy go way back.
All right.
You don't know what you're doing.
Pretty much sells itself, I think you'll find. Shall we? case, I'll see you later.
What do you do for New Year?
Oh, I'm busy, George. Big night. I'm sorry.
Foreboding about Judy. She seemed so doom-laden. There were awful press stories about her. Breakdowns, disastrous marriages, pills and booze and suicide attempts. Harry still loved her. But maybe all that drama and tragedy was part of the attraction. Somehow, I knew it was the beginning of the end for all of us.
Him up front and everything. I haven't heard a dicky bird. He never calls, he never tells me nothing.
Maybe he's a secret agent.
How do you mean?
I'm joking, Tommy. Relax, you'll have a stroke.
Yeah, but what am I supposed to do about it, though?
Well, you don't pay agents, not proper ones. They take it out of your earnings.
But I haven't got any earnings.
So don't pay him.
Look, I've got these done. See? Classy, eh?
Yeah, they're lovely. They're really pretty.
Even had an audition, right? Didn't get it, though. Director was a right bitch. It's a bit depressing. Don't know what I'd do if it worked for you. It'd be a mess.
Shut up.
Here, do you want to go backstage? Meet Judy? I just bumped into Bill and Johnny at the bar. They've invited us backstage. Do we have to? What's the matter?
You're talking to Ruby.
I can talk to Ruby anytime. I don't like those blokes, Harry.
They make me jumpy.
What's up? You want to go home?
Yeah. I do, as it happens. I bloody do.
You want to go home and all?
I don't mind.
All right. Piss off at Peria. Get a cab. Drop her off on the way home. You don't know what you're missing.
Harry.
You don't think I'm going to make it, do you?
It's a tough business. I should know. Some people don't get the breaks.
But I want to be somebody.
You are somebody.
But I don't know. I don't know who I am, Ruth. I don't know who. I don't even know who my real parents are. That's why I took up boxing, to make something of myself.
Well, I'm glad Harry made you stop. You're very handsome. You know that, don't you? Can you just undo my top button?
What?
Just undo the top button, it's a bit tricky.
Yeah. He's always making me do stuff. Stop boxing. Be in the gang, be an actor. I don't even want to be an actor, I think it's stupid.
He really cares about you. He really loves you.
Yeah, well, I don't know anything about love. How am I supposed to know? Never, ever.
What?
I've never even...
What?
I don't know a thing about birds.
Birds? Well, you never kissed a bird. I like it. Come here. Come here. Give me that.
Ruby.
Had 10 grand's worth busted at Felixstowe. Jock nearly got nicked when he went to pick it up.
What do you want me to do?
Get hold of Mooney, I'll take care of the rest. Where's Tommy?
I don't know.
He's in a funny mood when he got in last night. Didn't come anywhere near me. Keep an eye on him, Ruth. Don't want anyone getting nicked.
Serious Crime Squad are setting up an inquiry. The whole of the Dirty Squad could be indicted. But I'm reckoning we've got 6 months before we have to get out.
But we pay you to keep them off our backs. Can't you do nothing?
Nobody's paying the Serious Crime Squad, and even if they were, it won't make any difference. That's why they're called the Serious Crime Squad. Because they're serious.
Oh, bloody hell, George, this was all your stupid idea.
Bad timing, Ruby. Every boom's got a bust.
Well, not this bloody quickly.
They're still trying to make plenty of money. Harry or no Harry. But you've got to stick with me.
Stick with you? And then what?
I'll take early retirement. Set up on my own. Private detective. Somewhere nice, sunny, clean. Costa del Sol, perhaps.
Nice.
I mean it, Ruby. You could start again. Turn your back on this old sordid episode.
I know what you're talking about.
The porn, the strippers, the bank robber husband in Wandsworth, Nick. You're better than all that. We both are. Come and work for me. Be my personal assistant, as they say, and I will make you work like Harry does. Nothing as sordid as that. Not quite. Just, you know. keep me company.
Jesus. You're serious, ain't you?
Two more chips, please.
Harry, I need to talk to you.
Ruby, baby, come over. We're going to Johnny's for drinks. Guess who's going to be there?
Look, this is important.
I bet you can't guess.
Harry.
Judy fucking Garland, do you hear me?
Harry.
Hurry up, come over.
Shit.
It's nothing really. It's boys' boxing clubs. Oh. Deprived kids, you know, that sort of thing.
Oh, my. Yes, well, that sounds very rewarding.
It is. It is. As a matter of fact, I organise charity evenings.
Oh.
Maybe you'd like to come to one.
Well, you mean sing in your club?
Well, you could if you wanted to.
Oh, you British guys! You're such kidders!
Have another photo by the piano.
Oh, why not?
Oh, come on, you two. Come on, let me take a picture.
Okay, smile.
Happy to tell. Oh. That's gonna be beautiful. Lovely.
More gin, Judy.
Oh, lovely, thank you. Charming.
Judy, would you like a cigarette?
I'll take anything you have now.
Harry, listen to me.
Ruby, it's Judy Garland.
I don't care if it's the Bleeding Wizard of Oz. You just behave yourself, calm down.
What's wrong with you?
Mooney says we've got 6 months before it all goes tits up.
No. We haven't even started yet. This is a consumer society and I ain't consumed anything.
Well, you'll just have to think of something else.
Something else? I've done everything else.
Then you have to find a way of getting the next shipment into the country without Mooney's help.
Don't stop it now.
Here you are, Judy.
Oh, thank you.
So why Scandinavia?
I always wanted to go to Scandinavia. You toured there in the 50s, didn't you, Judy?
I did.
Oh, they just loved it.
Oh.
They worshipped it.
Stop.
In Scandinavia.
So, then a light bulb went on in my head, and I said to Mickey, Scandinavia, we'll tour Scandinavia, me and Johnny. A proper package tour, just like in the old days. Oh, come with us, Harry. Oh, come on. Keep us out of trouble, huh?
To Scandinavia.
Yes.
To Scandinavia.
Oh, you know what they're playing?
Okay,
they're playing.
Let's
go! Look at him. Stupid fucker.
Tommy.
If he got his tongue any further up her ass, he'd suffocate her. He's not thinking. He'll mess this up for all of us.
Yeah, well, you'll mess it up for all of us if you don't bite your tongue.
The sun is shining, come on, get happy. The Lord is waiting to take your hand.
Have you got everything? Tickets,
yeah.
Passport.
Yeah.
Got your money.
Yeah. Listen, I'm worried about Tommy. Something's bothering him. He's been right leery lately, throwing his weight around like he owns a racket. I don't know what's got into him. You keep him company while I'm away. He just needs a bit of, you know, a bit of affection, do you know what I mean?
I think so, Harry.
Thanks, Ruby. God, I love that boy.
I know you do. I know.
See ya.
Have a great time with Judy.
Just waggle your tits in their face and get your kit off. What's so difficult about that?
Shut up, Tommy.
Well, it's not the bloody Moulin Rouge, is it?
But I want this to be good.
Just keep the punters happy.
Wild thing, thing, girl.
Tommy, you're getting on my tits now. No, for sure.
Come on, woman, tell me.
Don't let me interrupt.
I'm enjoying the show.
Wild thing.
It's all right. Go on.
But I wanna know for sure. Come on, hold tight.
You thought any more about our agreement?
It wasn't exactly an agreement.
Oh, I think it was.
George.
Ruby, it's time to move on now. Serious. I'd be making myself scarce if I was you.
What do you mean? What are you talking about?
You and this lad, Tommy, the Oscar-winning disaster area? I can't imagine what would happen if Harry found out.
How do you know?
You'd be amazed what I know about people, Ruby. It's my job. I can't say I approve, but I'm willing to keep quiet about it. One condition. Yana de Nogueles. It's near Marbella. My little corner of the empire. My little place in the sun. Home from home. Oh, God, you love him.
It's just, I don't think so, George.
Maybe I can fix things so you live happy ever after. Or I can fix things so, well, put it this way, you don't want me for an enemy.
We need to talk about this, Tommy.
Don't just kiss me.
No.
I love you.
No, you don't. You just think you do.
No. Just kiss me.
No, it's over.
Over between us. It's just you and me in that room.
You bloody fool. People know about us.
Who?
Mooney.
Don't worry about Mooney. I know he knows.
How do you know?
Because I told him.
What?
I know Mr. Mooney better than you think. He likes me.
Why did you tell him about us?
Because he would have made you go to Spain if I didn't. He told me, the dirty bugger. He had to know you were spoken for, Ruby. Harry's past it now, Ruby. He's over the hill. He's out of fashion. Mooney needs somebody fresh, right? I put myself forward.
You idiot. Mooney's blackmailing me.
Ruby, it'll just be you and me running things.
I don't want to run things, Tommy. What about when Harry finds out?
I'll deal with Harry.
What's that?
What? This gun.
Jesus, Tommy.
He thinks he owns me. You can knock me about.
Look, you're making me nervous. You just put it back, eh?
Tommy! Where are you?
Shit.
Tommy!
Shit.
Judy cancelled Gertsburg, so I'll come back early.
That place is a pigsty. Oh, Harry!
Harry, this
ain't what you're thinking.
Come here, Hugh.
No.
Oh. Now I've seen it all. Go on, shoot me. Go on.
Don't push me, Harry.
Oh, but I am, Tommy. I am pushing you. Why not? What are you gonna do?
I'll fucking do you.
Go on and do me. Let's see what you got, you silly little sod. What you waiting for? You gonna break in a song? Hey! Hey! Ah, oh, you little bastard. Yeah. Go on and kill me!
Like a bad dream. A recurring dream where you've killed somebody and you can't live with yourself anymore.
Leave it there. And wait outside. You can keep me on with this.
What are we doing?
Family, so no one's reporting him missing. And if anyone asks you, you don't know where he is.
Harry.
I don't want to talk about it.
No, I just...
Shut up.
just want to say I'm sorry. Because I am. I'm so sorry.
If you hadn't shot the fucker, I would have.
You don't mean that.
How do you know what I mean? Just go home, Ruby.
I've been as bad as you could be. But I wasn't a bad person. Just a bad judge of character. So on the outside, Harry always looks in control. But inside he just wants to destroy himself. And without people like us around to make him feel loved, the destructiveness rules him. That's why the Stardust failed. That's why all his businesses fail. Because Harry Stark likes people. He needs people more than he realizes.
Fool that I am, for falling in love with you, and a fool that I am for thinking you loved me too. You took my heart, then played the part, oh, of little coquette, and my dreams just disappeared like the smoke from a cigarette. And oh yeah, fool that I.